Hello again. We're going to look now at intensifying screens, which help with optimization of conventional, that is, not digital, extraoral films. External intensifying screens are used with larger X-ray films, like panoramics and cephalostats, to reduce the necessary dose for image creation. They're not needed for digital PSP sensors. Those have a built-in phosphor layer that works in the same way. An intensifying screen is a sheet coated in crystals, called phosphors, which emit light when struck by X-rays. Intensifying screens absorb up to 40% of X-ray photons and turn them into light. When an intensifying screen is in contact with the film, an image is formed not only with the X-rays that trigger the film, but also by the light emitted by the screen. This effectively halves the dose of radiation needed to form an image. The film is sandwiched between two intensifying screens. If intensifying screens are used, the image is slightly blurred, as the fluorescent light produced tends to spread out. There are three main ways that screens are kept in optimal condition. Firstly, screens must be kept clean, so the fluorescent light they produce is not blocked by dirt. However, they must be cleaned very gently, so as not to damage the layer of crystals on their surface. Follow manufacturer's instructions exactly. Secondly, only put film into a cassette just before taking the X-ray, and remove the film for development immediately. The chemicals on the surface of the film can react with the crystals on the screen if in contact for too long. Finally, screens will wear out sooner or later from being scratched or abraded and will need replacement. You need to have a system to keep track of this. In the next lesson, we will look at digital sensors.